May 4th, 1942. The patient had previously expressed suicidal feelings, but never acted on them.
Yesterday, she injured herself badly, stabbing herself in the stomach with sharp, pointed scissors. Sedated, restrained, and transferred to an isolation cell.
May 10th. Transferred to the agitated ward for observation. Isolation, insulin, shock therapy. September 25th. Positive response to treatment. She replies to questions and remembers what happened, but doesn't want to give explanations. She claims to have memory lapses. Entire days about which she remembers nothing, she appears to be anxious and seeks reassurance. She fears she has done monstrous things in the blank periods for which she has no memory. November 11th, 1942. The patient speaks very little, refuses food, force-fed with a nasal cannula. February 2nd, 1943. The lack of kerosene for heating and the food shortage is claiming many victims in the institution. War spares nobody, not even these alienated creatures. Despite her young age, this patient has fallen ill owing to the cold and malnutrition.
Nobody laughs in here. I mean, really laughs. Not those crazy fools who laugh because people say they're mad. I don't know why they laugh out loud. They say I'm mad too, but I never feel like laughing. People used to laugh at me, but they were right, you know? You can't always cry and people laugh when they're afraid, don't they? It happened to you, not to me. It's better that way. They do that to show they're lucky. You mustn't take offense because it's true. And deep down, it's just like pity. If you see what I mean. But then you think about your own situation. And you laugh. Because you feel lucky that everything is gonna get better. That it's all shit. It's all shit, this place. You're not trying to tell me it's not true, are you? An intelligent person, educated, not like me. And if I can see it's a load of shit, just imagine how much better you understand it. No, come on. No. I feel fine here, you know? After all, I can do and say anything I want.
August 28th, 1942. We hereby notify you of the death of Ada T., mother of Renee T., a patient in your institution. No known relative. Sincerely yours, Onofrio P. I have no one left in the world. Nobody at all. Solitude is very strange. It muffles everything. Slows it down. It's an endless scream that makes no sound. A silent scream. I can't stop looking at myself. I will never leave this place. There is nobody up there for me. These walls have become my skin. And the wretched desperation within them is my soul without a voice. Here, nobody weeps anymore. I would love to feel life, desperation, anger. I've stopped dreaming, daydreaming, maybe even thinking. I've lived in a reality which has corroded me and has stripped me of everything, even my ability to feel pain.
May 5th, 1943. Renee's state of health is good. She is eating and speaking. Her spatial and temporal orientation is good. Therapy suspended. December 3rd. She calmly asks if she can leave the hospital. Evaluate patient for 6 months. May 2nd, 1944. Discharge denied despite favorable psychiatric opinion. The patient has no home or means of support. May 4th. The reasons why discharge is impossible are explained, and this is how Renee learns of her mother's death 2 years after. May 5th. She tried to kill herself in the night by hanging herself with a sheet, saved by the nurses. Restrained to her bed, she once more tried to kill herself by suffocation. The decision has been taken to perform a transformatory bodily.